Of humanity with no thought of return nor any desire for reward for the Contaminated by the light of the third logo, only responds to opportunity when the taking up this matter. However, I want to gather together some threads of thought in connection with the matter just dealt with. If we have carefully followed the data given about the huge manifestation on its own plane, and the fires of the causal body, we shall have noted the close resemblance between that egoic body, which is the force center, and certain aspects of the egoic manifestation. The causal body has been seen as a wheel of fire, containing within its periphery three focal points of energy, the permanent atoms. They are analogous, as earlier pointed out, to the seventh principle of each of the three aspects who are power, love, wisdom, and active intel. H-E-E-Z-Y-C-R-A-Y-A-N-D-S-O-L-A-R-F-I-R-E-545. Like it. Each of these focal points has its own internal autonomy, as seen in the spiruli, which are essentially streams of force, responding to stimulation and vibration, aroused within and without their limiting ring pass knot. The internal life of the permanent atom, and that which animates and produces its activity, is the life of the third aspect, the force playing upon and inserting the life of the second aspect. As evolution perceives the intensity of the life forces from within and those which affect it from without, grows gradually stronger and stronger, and the light of the permanent atoms increases, the petals of the lotus unfold, and the spokes of the radiatory fire come into action. Bear in mind here, that the permanent atoms are concerned with the substance aspect of existence or becoming, while the petals of the lotus, or the fiery spokes of the wheel, deal specifically with the psychical aspect, or the development of consciousness, the central nucleus, or the three inner petals, embodies the aspect of pure spirit. All three lines of evolution are proceeding simultaneously, and have a reflex action the one upon the other. It is this which produces the consequent perfection of unfoldment. It is neither possible nor desirable to follow each line of this threefold evolution separately, nor to consider them as dissociated from each other. Interplay is too accurate, and the mutual stimulation too important to be neglected by the student of egoic evolution. It is, as stated elsewhere, through the permanent atoms that the ego comes on reform of his objective world. He works upon and through his environment successfully or blindly just in so far as he can energize his permanent atom and bring the spiruli out of latency into potency. This only becomes possible as he unfolds the petals of the lotus. It must be remembered that the three lower petals when fully unfolded affect through 546-ATRE-ATISTONCOSMICFIRE. Their vitality, the three major spirits and the physical permanent atoms. As the second ring of petals gradually opens, the astral permanent atom undergoes a similar process, leading up to the full arousing of the spirit within the mental unit. Here I would point out that there is a slight difference in the case of the mental unit, for the four spiruli of the mental unit are aroused to full activity when the knowledge petal of the final three opens. The opening of the remaining two reveal the glowing threefold flower which lies at the center of egoic manifestation. It would be wise to sound a note of warning here in connection with this question of egoic unfoldment. suggestion set here has been that the formulation of the general plan of the human unfoldment is interpreted in terms of consciousness or a fire. In studying the subject with due personal application, the student should bear in mind the following facts. First, that according to the ray of the monad, soon the petals unfold.